Good morning, Shelley. How was your weekend?
Fine. Listen, a Detective O'Connor called. He found your purse.
Oh, good.
Yeah, what happened?
Well, I was out to dinner Friday night, and this guy just yanked my purse off the back of my chair and ran off.
Oh, my God. And your date didn't do anything?
He yanked my purse off the back of my chair and ran off.
Ooh, sounds like the big date went well.
Purse snatcher.
Wow, this is a pretty good month for you. We got the purse snatcher, the guy who wore clogs.
Oh, the guy who paid for dinner in dimes.
The pathological liar.
Yeah.
The guy who lived in his car.
Hey, yep. The pathological liar was the guy who lived in his car. Look, I'm just going through a little string of bad luck.
Well, you know, if it lasts long enough, it's not a string of bad luck anymore. It's your life. Now, it sounds to me like you should just pick the best weirdo, settle down, and squeeze out a few baby weirdos.
That is ridiculous. Now, maybe I haven't run into any lately, but there are a lot of great guys who would love to go out with me. I mean, it's not like I only attract weirdos.
I was following the most intoxicating fragrance down the hall, and... Well, it is you. This isn't the supply room.
Okay, let's have a staff meeting.
Honey, I know your pain. Since the divorce, I have suffered through my share of bad dates. But I have children who love me. You don't even have that.
Morning, everyone.
Hey, good morning, Jack.
Good morning, Jack.
So, what are we talking about?
How Robyn can't find a man.
Jack is not interested in my personal life.
You know, I read somewhere that most successful relationships come from people being set up by their friends.
That's how I met my wife.
Oh, who introduced you?
Her husband. Hey, you guys should all set each other up. That'll be fun.
I don't know. Last time I set two people up, it turned out to be a complete disaster. He was this sex-crazed dog, and she turned out to be this pushy, uptight, sexual...
Hey!
What? My Uncle Max and this old... Oh, you guys. Yeah, that didn't turn out so good either. I just think it's a bad idea.
Sammy, I know a model who is perfect for you.
Let me finish.
As a matter of fact, there's a picture of her. Yeah, here she is.
She's not a model. She's an underwear model. I'll take her.
She's got on granny panties.
Hey, she has to wear those. They're on sale.
Great. Now, if we could all look at the budget on the shampoo spot.
Okay, Sam, what do you got?
Well, there is this guy in my band, but I don't know how much fun he would be. He just broke up with his girlfriend, and he's all bummed out, because I guess they used to do it like 10 times a day or something.
Mine!
Sold! Well, that leaves the two of you.
Jack, Oprah Winfrey's on line one. She needs a favor.
Oh, God, I never should have moved next door to her. Every time she has one of those slumber parties, I get Stedman. Let's play cards, Jack. Let's watch the game, Jack. Want to make some jiffy pop, Jack?
So we're gonna fix each other up. This could be fun. Let me see. Who would be good for Robyn? Robyn Buckley. Woman of the 90s. Sazz, pizzazz, a big old... job.
I don't think so. You're just gonna set me up with some jerk and try and make me look stupid because I don't want to have anything to do with you.
You think that bothers me? You did me a huge-ass favor by ruining our day, and to prove it, I will fix you up with the greatest guy ever.
You're not that big a person.
Not that big a person. Sam, tell her how big I am.
I really don't feel comfortable vouching for your bigness.
Well, I'm a bigger person than you, and you're not even big enough to let me prove that I'm a bigger person than you.
Fine. You know what? I will play your little game. I will set you up with somebody that will rock your world.
Bring it on.
Oh, I will.
Okay.
Hey, I can date her and get 40% off Kix cereal. This woman is gonna walk in here to meet me.
What did you do to her picture?
Nothing.
Did you try and erase her bra?
It was late. I was drunk.
Nervous?
Oh, I'm fine. You know, I know my way around a bad day. You're the one that looks a little nervous.
Hey, I'm not nervous. I just don't know why we had to meet our dates here. This is gonna throw off my whole blind date system.
You have a system?
Yeah, I like to pick a woman up at her house. That way, the first time she sees me, I'm behind the wheel of a Porsche.
Let her know that I have class.
Aren't you standing in her doorway the first time she sees you?
No. If you honk enough times, they come out.
Dude.
Shelly, this is Rich Ackerman.
Hey.
Sweet. Is there a phone around here? I got paged by my dad.
Right over there, dude.
Thanks, dude.
Sammy, how old is that guy?
I don't know, like 22?
22? Sweet.
Oh my God, this is like a dream, only she's in color and my Aunt Claire isn't chasing me on a pogo stick.
Sabrina Shea, this is Sam Wagner. Sam Wagner, Sabrina Shea.
I know, I recognize her from the thing I have in my pants. Oh, a picture. This is with the... Hey, how about we get a drink?
Okay.
Whoa, if there is a God, that is my date.
Tammy.
See you Sunday, Jesus.
Milo, this is Tammy. Tammy, this is Milo.
How you doing?
A lot better now.
So, underwear. That sounds like fun. I mean, you know, modeling underwear. Not that I've ever done it. Professionally.
Well, it's okay, but like any job, it gets old. Uh-huh. I'm so sick of it lately that I can't even wear underwear if I'm not working.
Oh, you mean like, Oh my God.
You are so cute. Are you nervous? Oh, you're sweating.
Well, it's just a little...
I'm so sorry. Oh, I can't believe I just did that.
That's okay. The glasses here are very slippery. They're famous for that. You missed a spot.
Hey, Milo.
Hey, Rob.
Huh? Yeah, see him, not bad.
Rob Cooper, Robin Buckley, Dr. Rob Cooper.
Oh, tree surgeon?
No, actually, I'm a pediatric cardiologist.
Oh.
He saves children's lives. Good enough for you? You guys go have fun.
So, Milo, what's the joke?
What?
With Ralph, what's wrong with him?
Nothing. There is no joke. I want her to know that I'm the bigger person.
So there's nothing wrong with her?
Nope.
That's gonna drive her nuts.
Mm-hmm. Being the bigger person is great.
Boy, did I not want to do this, but now that I see how beautiful you are, I'm glad I did.
Yeah, right.
Oh, well, I know a great little Italian restaurant. It's not very far from
I,
here.
Figured that we eat here.
Oh. Well, okay, I'll go get us a table.
A doctor who looks like that? Jump him. Stat.
Shelly, please. Milo's not looking to set me up with a great guy. He's setting me up to look like a fool. But we'll see who's laughing Monday morning.
What did you do?
Let's just say Tammy's got a few quirks.
Sorry about that. My dad gets really nervous when I take his car.
Oh, I will.
Robyn, they're just setting up our table.
Good. So, pediatric cardiologist. Spell that.
I can't believe Robyn came through for me. This girl is hot.
Mine's not wearing underwear. Sabrina, where's the blue car? Okay.
Sam, since when did you drive a caddy?
Borrowed it. The Hyundai, though economical and gaining in popularity, still not a babe magnet.
It's not about the car, man. Tammy, we're in the Porsche.
So I was thinking maybe we'd start with dinner at the 95th, nice bottle of wine, couple of thick steaks, beautiful view of the city.
Or we could grab some takeout and go back to my place.
We can do that.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
No. Just my thumb.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Could you open it?
Tell the attending at county that Dr. Cooper performed the emergency tracheotomy. Oh, and tell him to hold on to that pen. It was my grandfather's. Oh. Sorry.
Okay, maybe you are a doctor, but what is wrong with you?
Well, we all have our flaws. I mean, you, for instance, seem a little hostile.
What are you, married?
No.
Gay?
I don't think so.
I bet you have one of those house arrest bracelets around your ankle, don't you? Oh, Armani socks.
You know what, Robyn? Why don't we just forget about tonight?
You're just gonna walk out? That's it? You're gonna leave before the big joke?
I'm sorry, did you want to tell me a joke?
Oh, come on. Now, Milo's gonna be mad if you leave without doing whatever you guys plan to make me look stupid.
Look, I don't know what kind of weird thing you've got going on with Milo, but the truth is, I don't really know him.
What?
We met playing basketball at the Y. He said he knew a nice, intelligent woman he thought I might like.
You don't know Milo?
Not really. It doesn't sound like he knows you that well either. Look, I'm just gonna go.
Wait. Now, if you go, that means that there's no joke. And you actually are a great guy?
Okay.
Oh my God, you're a great guy. Hey, how are you? Please, sit down. There, have some wine. Or would you prefer champagne? Waiter!
Look, I really don't think...
Ralph, I am sorry for the way that I was acting, but you see, Milo is a very small, shallow, immature person, and I was sure that he was going to try and pull something tonight. In fact, oh, you're going to love this. I was so sure that he was going to try and mess with me that I set him up with this woman who, oh, dear God. Do you mind if we go for a little ride?
Warned me that all you would do during dinner was stare at my chest.
She said that?
And since I couldn't really give you a good look at the restaurant, I just figured we'd come back here.
I'll go put the food in the fridge.
What's your neck size?
I'm sorry, what?
Never mind. I'll just guess.
Where'd you grow up?
In the suburbs. Look, if this is a bad night for you, maybe we can
No, No. This won't take long. So, suburbs. That must have been suburban.
Yeah. Where are we going?
Well, I don't know yet. Look, Ralph, I know this all seems a little silly, but this will only take a few minutes. And then afterwards, I know this really great jazz club where we can, you know, talk. I just need to find my assistant. What? I need to talk to you.
Okay.
Just a second, okay.
Now?
Yes, now. Hold on.
I can see your date is going well.
Hi, Ralph.
Hello.
Did you figure out what's wrong with him?
Yes. Nothing.
Wow. So I guess that makes Milo the bigger person.
Not if I can find him before. I gotta find him. Where'd they go?
I don't know. You know, maybe Sammy knows. They all left together.
Well, where's Sam?
Bistro Henry. Can I go now? Because I'm working against a 12 o'clock curfew here.
Go.
sorry about your head.
Not your fault. Lobster claws can be very unpredictable.
Oh, I am just such a klutz.
No, it's fine, it's fine. Things happen. Hands get caught in doors. Lobster claws fly. High-heeled shoes go right through boots.
Sam, you are so amazing. I mean, most guys are not as understanding as you are.
Most guys don't have my health plan.
I really, really like you.
Wow. Sabrina, that is so nice. I mean, hearing you say that while actually touching me makes me realize that I'm on fire. Oh my God, you've lit me on fire. It's fine. It's really, it's no big deal. It's oh. I think he went over. Maybe I should show you.
Awfully nice of you to treat Sam. Sam, did you thank Dr. Cooper?
Thanks, Dr. Cooper.
Why aren't they answering?
What the hell is going on there? What is your friend, a murderer?
Well, let's just say she's a very kinky girl.
The kind you don't take home to mother?
She's a freak.
A super freak?
She's super freaky. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Come on.
Oh. Key.
Oh, great.
Oh. Holy.
Wow.
Oh. I know. Let me just get you down, okay?
Okay. I'm going now.
Hey, check this out.
Sam!
Sorry, but this is amazing. Come on.
Could you give me a hand here, please? If I could just get a corner. Oh, got it!
Go away! Morning.
Morning.
All right, go ahead, get it out, man. All right, that's enough, man. Okay, can we at least keep this amongst ourselves?
Oh, yeah, of course. I mean, it's your personal life. What you do behind closed doors, suspended in midair, is your business.
Thank you.
Ah, good morning, Houdini.
Sam, you actually call people at their houses over the weekend?
Good morning, everyone. Let's get to work and not waste a bunch of time talking about our weekends.
Pardon me. Maybe I should step aside since there's no way you can get around such a big person.
Excuse me?
I'm the bigger person. I set you up with a great guy who thinks you're a freak, by the way, and you used this opportunity to play a practical joke. Now, I could have gotten seriously hurt. Lucky for you, all I received was a nasty rash from the leather straps.
Oh, yes. That can sting. This is not the storage room.
Monday morning meeting, everyone.
I'd like to hear you say it.
What?
That I'm the bigger person.
Look, Milo, I blew it with a pediatric cardiologist, the only decent guy that I have met in months. I think I've suffered enough.
Okay, if you say it, I think I can get you another date with Ralph. Paging Dr. Cooper.
Your last date was a criminal.
All right. Maybe in this particular case, on this one night, in a small way,
hey.
All right, in a regular size way, you were the bigger person.
Thank you. I'll call Ralph. Hey, Ralph, what's up? It's Milo. Listen, man, I think you got the wrong impression about my friend Robyn. Nah, she ain't crazy. No, actually, she's a really nice person, and I was hoping that you'd give her another shot. Yeah? Cool.
You're doing your thing.
Do you think she'll have a problem with me wearing women's underwear?
Say what?
Women's underwear. I like to wear it.
I think she'd like that very much. All right.
What?
Oh, no, nothing. He's just got a little surprise for you.